And welcome to Access Restaurant Management System. So let me show you guys how this system works. Okay, you can order any of these meals and just click on save, and you can also view the orders, everything on the or the database actually. Okay, go back to the form. To order new meal, just click on add sales and enter whatever you want, and there, those are your orders. Then you all just need to do is click on menu, and there you get all of this, the price and so on. And you can come in here and just validate what we have in here. Maybe 9.46, that's 9.46 plus 38.36, yeah, that's correct. All right, just add that up. Okay, that's what that gives you. Then you can also add the tax there. Okay, just to check the price. So what I will do now is to take you guys straight on to Access Development Environment, and we'll put one of these very beautiful tutorial together. Okay, let's save that and check on that. Okay, that's the whole information there. Alright, and let's go on to Access now. And welcome to Microsoft Access Restaurant Management System. I'm going to start by clicking on Create. And I'll select a table. And let's go straight to the design and design our table. But first thing first, let me just call that table restaurant. Right, that's the name of my table. Okay, so I'll enter as follows. The first will be, let's say, chicken burger. And let's say we also have fillet or fish. Then we have cheeseburger, and let's say finally we also have hamburger. Those are the menu that we have on our list, and each of these ones, let me change it to, I think short is okay. I'm just gonna get rid of that, I don't need that. Okay, I also have, the other thing is drinks. Let's say we have tea, we have maybe cola, and let's say we have coffee, orange, and maybe, let's say, iced tea or whatever. So those are the types of drinks that we have on board. Okay, so the next thing is, let's add maybe cost of drinks, cost of meal, right? Okay, and then we have subtotal, tax, and total, right? So those are the fields for my restaurant management system. Okay, let's save it. But just before I continue, I'd like to draw your attention to the calculator that will be embedded into this restaurant management system. The calculator is already developed anyway, which is right here. There's a calculator here. So if you go to YouTube, you should be able to see this calculator. And here I have the link for the tutorial, for the calculator tutorial. That is the link. It was my last video developed in Access. Alright, I'm going to continue. Now let's come straight to our table here. I intend to convert it all to a form. Okay, instead of starting a new form all over, if you want, you can always click on new form and just start it all over. That is how you start a new form. Well, I'm not going to do that. I'll just continue straight with the calculator. So let's double click on, or let's select the calculator and just go to the design view of this calculator. Right, that's the design view of the calculator. I'm going to now extend this that much so that I have enough room to carry out the whole project, and select it all. Let's move it aside. All right, okay, so if I run it now, let's see how it's gonna look like. So, okay, that means I can still move it to the right. Okay, let's move it to the right a little bit more. Okay, that's it. So the next thing is, I will now come straight to the frame here, or option group, and draw. Okay, then I'm going to cancel that because I don't want any option. So let's select this very frame and select the properties there, and let's go to both width, and I'm going to change that both width to about 4. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, I can even copy it and paste it there for another. Yeah, right, I might need maybe one or two more. Let's paste that there, drag it down here. Maybe one more, let's see. Okay, I will design as I go along anyway. Alright, this last one, I'm going to change this one. That will be my heading. Okay, and bring it up here and just drag it along. Then I now need a label. That's a label. Dump the label in there and just enter restaurant. Management system. Okay, select it all. And let's go to format up here. Okay, make sure it's selected. Go to format and change it to maybe 40. And let's change the color to black. Let's open it up. Alright, make it bold. Right, that's it. It is centered. Okay, that's fine. The next thing I like to do is, let's come back to home. If I decide to run it, this is how it looks for now. Okay, I'm gonna close that. I'm using this as my button to close it because I have some other codes in there. All right, but before I continue, maybe I should show you guys what I'm talking about. Go back in here. All right, I've actually created a system. When it's run, you will not see any of this ribbon. Okay, and it's only a single line of code. To achieve that, all you need to do is select your form. Okay, go straight to the property. Let's come straight to event and just click on that. Right in here, select the form. You should be able to see the form there. And right underneath here, I have the lines of codes. There's the lines of code that get rid of the ribbon. Okay, I intend to leave that code there, or maybe I'm going to cut that lines of code off, and this is the other one that I using enabling the system. I'll save it and use, maybe use a button to carry that out, to carry boot functions out. Okay, right underneath here, I might as well just create two buttons. Yeah, let's create two buttons. Let's see if I have enough room first. I think I do have enough room. Yeah, that'll be fine. I will have enough room. All right. Okay. Let's create the first button. Oh no. Let's leave that alone. And let's draw. Yeah, let's draw that here. Let's across and cancel that. Get rid of this. And maybe change, go to the property, change that to change the border style. Let's make that 4 as well. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Right, let's create a button. The first button. And that very button, I'm gonna cancel that because I intend to use it to maximize the form to get rid of the ribbon. So let's go to the properties and just give it BTN, maybe full screen. Or no ribbon. Let's call it no ribbon. No ribbon. Okay, that's it. Let's change that to no ribbon. All right, that's what the button is called. And create another one. Okay, get rid of that and just maybe change that to BTN enable. Ribbon. And this one is enable ribbon. Right. One is, the other one is no ribbon, or maybe we should change that to disable ribbon, enable ribbon. Okay. Disable. Disable ribbon and enable ribbon. That's it. Now, select the first one. Come straight to the event here. And you can always select this arrow and then click on event procedure and then click on those three lines. You see where it says no ribbon? And just paste those lines of code right in there. That is it. Alright. All these other lines of code that you guys are seeing, those are the lines of code for the calculator. Alright. Supposing I cut this off, have a good look at it. That's for button 7, button 8, button 9. Those are the variables I declared. Button 0, 1, 2. Button 3, 4, 5. Button 6. And in here, I have the operator plus. Okay. That's for the plus right here, this very one. This. So back on the code. And then in here, I have backspace. This is for backspace, which is right here. Okay, so I advise you guys to have a good look at this link here, so that you can, you'll be able to create that yourself. Okay, I'll now come straight to my main project. Let me put that very first line of code right up here. Okay, that is for no ribbon. Now the other one, let me just copy this. If you look at this, study this line of code, says do command show taskbar. The taskbar that you want to show is ribbon and comma. Don't show the taskbar. Alright, now for the next button, which is enable ribbon, make sure it's selected. Come straight to the events right there. You can do repeat the same thing, click on the procedure, or just click on this three dotted button there and select code builder. Click on okay, just paste that in there. Instead of no ribbon, you change this to yes ribbon. Alright, okay, to verify what I've just done, you can type out all of the codes just to show you that the system do recognize the command. Do command dot show show taskbar, and what taskbar do you want to use? Show that will be ribbon on comma AC taskbar yes. That is it. Save that. If I go to my system now and just try this out, but the first thing is I would like this very one to show the ribbon. I like the system not to show the ribbon, that so that means we must add one of those commands onto form load, which is right here. Okay, for the form load, let's copy this. That is the form load that goes in there, and save that. So if I run the program, that is what you guys will get. Okay, you might not be able to see this properly. Let's say enable ribbon and come back in here so that I move it all up. So let's go to the design and just move it a little bit up. I'm gonna need a button to control, or maybe just copy one of these. Let's copy that. The button to control the exit. Bring that right down. Yeah. That's my exit there. So you can right click and select the property. And let's come to all in here. I'm just going to change that to exit. And right up here, change that to BTN exit. Okay, that's the name of that very component. Now the other thing you guys might not be or might not have noticed, or you may have noticed it, is that the colors looks a little bit too dull. So I'm going to go to format and just change it to black. Maybe increase the font size to maybe 12. Yeah, make that bold. Alright, looks a little bit pronounced. That's fine. What about the color for the back color for each button? So I'm going to change that from blue to gray. Light gray. That is fine. Okay. Now, this very button, exit. Make sure exit button is selected. Now go to event and select the three buttons, the three dots there, and just click on code builder. Select okay. Once code builder is selected, right in there I'm going to use the following variable. I said dim I exit as VB, so now the VB message box result is very one. Then I exit equals message box and my message box is going to be Let's see. Confirm. If you want to exit. Right. Comma. Let's say VB question. Plus VB yes, no. Right there. Then let's add another command. This one is just gonna be my title, so I'll just call that restaurant. Restaurant management systems. Close that. Then let's use. Oh, there should be a bracket there. Sorry. Okay, let's use an if statement. If I exit equals VB yes, then what we want is the system to, when the system to exit, and that will be in this case do command dot close. Okay, and that's going to be AC form. We're talking about the form. Close the form, and let's refer to the form by name. Me dot name. Right, and end if. So that's it. So those are the lines of code for exit from here. Okay. And these are for ribbon. No ribbon and yes ribbon. Okay. So maybe just paste that where you can see both. Yeah. For ribbon, and these are for exit. So let's go back straight to our form. If I run the system now, let's say we come to home and just click on that. I can always exit. No, I do not want to exit. I like to enable ribbon. Right, which means I'm gonna have to be forced to use my scroll bar there. Okay, let's finish up the design of the interface. So I'm gonna come here. Just go straight to design. Let's go to the table itself. Double click on the table and let's have a good look at this design of the table again. That's what we have. We have how many? Okay, we have about 5 of those. Maybe we should add 1 or 2 more. Let me add 1 or 2 more anyway. I think I'm gonna call that, let's say, chicken legend. Then we also have, let's say, chicken nuggets. All right, I think that should do it now. Save. Let's go straight to the form and enable ribbon. Now, make sure you now right click on the form itself, then let's select form property, this very one. Yeah, that's more like it. Now, let's check all, and in here, in all, you see where it says record source. Alright, drop this down and let's select the table called restaurant. Once that is selected, you now come up here, add existing fields. Click on that. Those are the existing fields. We can now add those fields to our main project here. Okay, we may have to move this. Let's see. Okay, now let's say fillets and so on. We can just move those ones in here. Let's drag them in. Alright, we have Boulder here. And in here we have the hamburger. Okay, here, anything to do with chicken. Yeah, here, drag that and drop it here. And we have chicken here again. And another chicken here. Alright. Okay. Now, what about the drinks? If we have all of those in there, we need drinks. Drinks. Okay. Let's move those ones down here. We have the first drink there. The other drink. Another one here. Right, all of the drinks are in there. Okay, we now need total, subtotal. Drag that and put that in here. So if I run it, let's close this first. Make sure it's saved. Close that. Alright, that's fine. There. Okay. So, but we need to tidy up a little bit. So let me just tidy it up and I'll get back to you. This is how the whole interface looks now. Okay, the next thing we want to do is to add more buttons here and then start with the coding. But before then, I would like to prevent this. See all this? You can enter whatever data in there. So I would like that not to be happening. Yeah, so what I'll do is select each of them. Let's come to property. And in there, I'm going to select after update. You look at the event after update. Click on that and just select that. So, after update, what I want the system to do is, if not, is number or is numeric and what we're talking about is this. I'm gonna copy it, fillet or fish dot value, then on fillet or fish equals clear. I want it to clear whatever data is entered. So let's save that and just try it out. So if I run it now and enter something that is not, you see that's deleted. I know you might be wondering, why didn't we use set it to number? But if we set it to number, I'm not happy with the way it responds. And I'm going to repeat exactly the same thing to all of this. So let's come in here and just come right down here. Right. If you're wondering, let me show you what I was talking about. If I set this property in the design view to, if I set it to numbers, let's close this and come in here, open up the table. Okay, I'm going to change that of cheeseburger, this very one. Let's come in right here. If I change the cheeseburger to numbers, right, look at that, cheeseburger. Okay, look at what's going to happen now. Save, yes, we save it. Okay, let's close that and open up the table. Right. It is cheeseburger, this very one. If I enter, okay, look at that. See, the system would not clear it, but this is the message that pops up. Okay, so I'm going to go back and change that of cheeseburger. I will change it back to just numbers, just to text, sorry. Let's save it, close this, come right in here, just come here, design cheeseburger, change it back to short text and save. So that is fine, that's how I prefer it. So might as well just use ordinary, use those simple lines of code that you guys saw earlier. So now let's open this and go to design view and repeat exactly the same thing for the rest of this component. So the next one is going to be hamburger. So let's go to the property of hamburger and we come into, okay, after update for the hamburger, that is hamburger right down here. Paste that simple line of code and just change the object to hamburger and this as well. Right, so I'll repeat the same thing for fillet meal. And that's fillet meal up there. Let's copy that and do that. Copy, paste, and let's change the name. So I will now speed that up and get back to you guys. Okay, I've finished the validation of the event after update for all of the text box on the system. So what we need to do now is let's add some buttons here, right here. Okay, the first thing I like to do is to make sure you use Control Z is highlighted, is checked, so I can then click on the button, come in here. I want to add, let's add updates or add new. Okay, that's fine. Let's add new. Yeah. So add new sales or whatever. Yeah, add new sales. Okay, click next and it's going to be called BTN add new sales. As it finish, so that will automatically add the new sales for me. The next one is, let me get another one, and this one will be, let's go for, okay, we should be able to delete records, right, if there's any mistake with sales, delete sales. All right, so that's gonna be BTN delete sales. That's good. Then let's add another one. I think we need to be able to save, right? Save record. Yeah, that is fine. You notice I'm only using text, I'm not using picture box because I don't need that. I prefer the text. Okay, that's going to be BTN save. Right. There. I think that might be all for now. But just to be on the safe side, let's see, I'm gonna need one for the additions and so on, anyway. Let's see, close, I already have that, open form now. Alright, I think that should do it. Navigate, okay, I should be able to navigate Yeah, let's go for next and previous. Right, we have one for BTN Navigate. We have one and another one. Let's enter another one for previous. BTN previous. Okay, there we go. So they are all ready now. All I just need to do is to tidy up those buttons and I'll get back to you guys. Okay guys, this is how the interface looks right now. Okay, I may have to settle for that, but I need one more button across all these buttons here. You can add sales, you can go to next, you can go back to previous, that's fine. I can even delete that. That record is gone, which is fine. Okay, disable and enable ribbon. I can disable it, so that's fine. All of those are working, but I now need a button just to carry out all of the calculation, and that'll be the end of my tutorial really. So let's enable the ribbon and come straight into design view. Now come right down here. I'm going to copy exit. Let's just copy that and paste it right in there. I think it's up there somewhere here. And just drag it down. I want that right in here. Okay. Now let's go to design and properties. Right in here, I'm going to give it a name. I'll call it BTN. BTN cost. Let's see. Cost. And that will be the name. I need to be cost of meal. Right. That's it done. Okay. Now all of the calculation will be in here, so the first thing I'd like to do is let's go to event right there, procedure, and yeah, we have a place for it. But one thing I'd like to do is right underneath here, let me declare an array which will be M. Okay, as double, right? The M actually means male, so let's comment male there. Right, so array always starts from zero. I'm going to say array zero equals fillet underscore o fish. That's the first one, and the second one is M1 is going to be cheeseburger. That's the second one. Let's see the names of the others. We have hamburger. Let's copy that. Come in here. M2 equals hamburger. Followed by fillet meal, burger meal. So let's copy this, we can remember that. Then that is equals fillet meal, M4 equals burger meal. Okay, I believe you guys get the whole idea, so I'm going to repeat exactly the same thing for the rest, the ones that I have in here. Alright, so Let's continue. So let me just speed that up. Okay, so far this is how it all looks. All of the different meals and drinks have been assigned to an array, and in array 13 all of these from 0 array 0 to array 7, 8 of those are added onto array 13, and the drinks are added onto array 14, that's from 8 to 12. Okay, now array 13 is now assigned to the component called cost of meal, and 14 assigned to the component called cost of drinks, and right here at the components. So what will happen is this will tell us the cost of drinks and this tell us the cost of meal. So let's run it and see. If I enter, let's say, let's go for add new sales, and in here we have maybe two fillet, but the thing, we also need the price of each of these. Okay, that's an error on my side. Okay, we get that sorted. Right, we have, okay, we'll get rid of that. We need drinks here. Let's see, then we click on add. So it's now telling us how many drinks and the cost of meal. So this will be added together to get us, to give us the cost of the subtotal, total, tax and total. And maybe we should change this to currency. Let's change this to currency. And now this only tell you how many fillet of fish the customer wants. So we need to get a price for each item. Okay, let's enable, come in here. That's fine, it's working anyway. You just need to make up a price. I'm gonna make that up. Let's say the price of a fillet of fish, I'm making this up, is 1.5, and here multiply that by maybe 1.3 or 1.2 fillet meal, maybe 3.5 burger meal, multiply by 3.2, and the next one here is burger, multiply that by 1.97, 1.95 nuggets, let's say 2.5. Now T at 0.99, cola, multiply that by 1.2. Right, so okay, that's it guys. So we now have price for our meal. You guys can change it to whatever you like. So that's what I'm gonna go for. I say 0.0 that. So they all have price now, which is fine. We're gonna save it. Let's go in here and convert this to currency. So make sure it's saved. Close everything, and I need to open up the table and go to design view, and in here these two will become currency. Yeah, let's see, that's fine. Okay, all sorted. Let's go back into, or onto the form, Okay, in the form here, let's get our ribbon now. Let's now add all of these onto the total. Okay, design codes right here. I'm going to declare another. Okay, I'm going to just assign another of my array. So array 15 equals M13 plus M14. Okay, then let's multiply that by maybe 0.4, maybe 0.,, because it's full, 0.3. That is supposed to be the tax divided by 100. Well, we can just declare tax up there somewhere. So we have one here and one more, I think. Yeah, that should do it. All right, we can say dip game. Let's say food tax as double, and food tax this very one equals 0.35. So this place here, this one would become food tax. Yeah. All right, that's the tax. Now, M16 equals, we now need to add these two. This plus all of these. Okay, that's right. So this one will be 13. 14. So that is M16. Let's correct that. Right. That's M16, and that would be the total, really. So we can just say total equals array 16. M16. That is total. Now, what about subtotal? Sub underscore total equals these two. So we can get rid of this. One, just one. Right. They don't have to be there though. So that is subtotal. What about tax? Tax equals M16. There, that is the tax. This one right here. That's our tax there. This is just a comment. No, it's M15. Sorry. M15. Because we added everything here to get the total. Okay, that's fine. Let's run it and see. Save all of that and come on to the form and let's give that a try. Save whatever we have in there. Add new data and we want that. Okay, what about drinks? We want two of this. Yeah. Now maybe one iced tea. I want hamburger as well. And this. Nuggets. If we click on this, there we go, guys. You see that? And then you can click on save and have a look at what you've done, or the sales in on the table. right there, guys. Okay, you see that? Okay, that's the advantage or the benefit of a system like this. Go back in there. Oh, I just noticed an error there in the spelling. Let's come back in here and just get that fixed. Then we can call it the end of this tutorial. Right there, there's an R missing. Good. Sorted. Okay, guys, with that, I'm going to call it the end of this tutorial. I suppose you guys enjoyed. And please do subscribe. You guys have a nice day now. Bye for now.